We are now live with the unofficial Google Plus Film Festival. Welcome. We are here with Mark Gant, who is our gracious host, and we're going to talk about our web series Block 3 after we watch our films. But Mark, go ahead and take it away.
Thanks, Adam. Just want to take a minute to welcome and thank you for joining the UGPFF, and of course, thank you to all our filmmakers and web series creators from around the world. We are very excited to have you a part of this event. My name is Mark Gant. I'm an actor, filmmaker, probably best known for the web series The Bannon Way that I created.
We are now live with the unofficial Google Plus Film Festival. Welcome. We are here with Mark Gant, who is our gracious host, and we're going to talk about our web series Block 3 after we watch our films. But Mark, go ahead and take it away.
Thanks, Adam.
Did you find it?
You guys there? You guys there?
Yep.
Okay.
Sorry about that. I was getting the playback from the link. So I'm hearing myself repeat it twice as it was going. I don't know if you guys heard that.
I've done that already 100 times. Go ahead, Mark.
Yeah. I need some more wine, apparently. So anyway, what's that? All right, so anyway, what I was saying was, my name is Mark Gant. I'm an actor and filmmaker, probably best known for The Bannon Way on Sony's Crackle.com. I wanted to first thank Adam J. Cohen, the founder, who has made this all possible from an idea that he had 3 years ago. This entire festival is a grassroots movement and is available to you completely free of charge. However, there are still many expenses, so we ask if you can help support the UGPFF by purchasing virtual tickets and weekend passes for the show anytime at our website, which is ugpff.com/support. You know,
here,
every penny
right
really does count.
Right there, you can see it.
Okay. So this is how the UGPFF works. You can watch the festival from Google+, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, or on our site at ugpff.com. Right now, you have the option of staying here to watch the entire block of web series in the Google Plus Hangout, or if you prefer and you want a more cinematic viewing experience, you can go to ugpff.com/web3, that's a number 3, to view the entire block right now. Okay, so make sure you come back here, though, because after the screening, we're going to do a little live Q&A session with the other filmmakers, with the web series creators, and they're all from around the globe. So this web series block you're about to see has projects from the U.S. and U.K. and Italy. So sit back and enjoy, and we'll see you guys in 90 minutes.
Okay.
Hey, Adam, we can't hear you.
Okay, go. Enjoy the films. Visit us at ugpff.com/web3 and return here in 90 minutes so that we can talk with all the creators.
Thanks, guys, for being here.
Thank you.
Hey, Hunter. Can you hear me?
Hello?
Hey, yeah, we're just kind of quietly watching the films that are being seen at that website that you can see.
Okay.
We'll come back in about an hour. So you can just mute. I'll go ahead and turn your mic down. You can just hang out and watch the films, and we'll come back in a little bit.
Awesome. Sounds good. Can you hear me?
Yeah, you sound great.
Oh, awesome. Okay.
Okay. Thanks.
Sounds good.
Story that I did have a good
Oh my god. When she said that, I was like, okay. God damn it, that's why you do this. I was pissed because I was like,
yep, change somebody's world.
Yep, you did. I agree.
You know, it's funny, I saw that project and I'm like, I can't read the test. The whole news thing. You seen that?
It was, no, it was funny. It was different.
Okay, then maybe it was better.
It was funny, quite fun. It was, I liked it. I really did. I laughed a lot. But I didn't think it was from a seasoned veteran writer from sitcom, but I should have known. So I know the kind of shit that people like Pasha write. And that's what it was. It was. Another David. Another Jew from New York, by the way.
Yep.
David Simon? Yeah, absolutely.
So on the surface, do you think this was a success?
Doing about
such incredible engagement from the people in the festival. Mm-hmm. We are doing.
I agree. And the more you can come in and like that last web series, I have to say it's all about remember. I think it was last year, if not the first year. Somebody came in and said, "Hey, you know how to be in a hangout?" They asked about, you know, how to be in a hangout kind of thing. I don't remember who it was, but I remember they said it's all about just having a good time. And I feel like we haven't done that a lot. We haven't been having a good enough time.
Yep.
And that's why I feel like that, like the last hangout was our Q&A was the best one in a while because everybody was like drinking, kind of having a good time.
Yeah, guard was down.
And it wasn't like, oh, I need to act like I'm on a TV show or the Jay Leno show, and including me, you know. And it's hard because it's, you feel, yeah, and I don't think that's what I think it needs to be, this relaxed, chill thing, which is why I was a little upset to see Gant so tense. I really didn't expect that. But I think he did like a typical actor was just trying to read his script. I'm
bummed
that he feels hurt, and
I don't
want him to feel.
You know, I haven't called him. I'm trying to make peace, but Tijuana's pretty cool.
Yeah, what are they still kids there?
They're going home now. They just finished Web Series Block 3.
Uh-huh.
They said it's very cold there.
Really?
But everyone, but they, you know, but it was fun. And they really liked the ones with the college boys.
Oh, I bet they did. Yeah. So they told the ones they just recently watched?
Yeah. They destroyed the Alpha Gamma.
Yeah, destroyed the Alpha Gamma's?
Hey, Adam? Adam, can you hear me by chance?
I think right now the biggest issue with the festival, other than we just don't have obviously the support, is that we can't stream the films to hang out.
I
Can anyone hear me? Hello? Anyone there?
Can anyone hear me?
Oh, that was weird. An echo. It's on delay. Okay.
Hello? Anyone there? Can anyone hear me?
Oh, that was weird. Echo. Oh boy. It's weird. Okay.
Okay.
So, felt like things had changed. For a little while, it didn't even hurt. Like the nerves had been seared so much, there wasn't any pain. I could hear the pavement whispering to itself. I kept trying to think of something to tell myself to make it better.
All right, we are back with the unofficial Google Plus Film Festival. We just finished watching our third block of web series, and we had some amazing content there. Thank you, everybody, for sticking around and checking out some of the great stuff that's being made all over the world. We had stuff from L.A., from Italy, and a number of other places as well, some from the U.K. So we're just giving people a chance to kick back in. Mark is joining us, and we're going to just go ahead and discuss a little bit more about web series. Mark, are you there?
Great. Yeah, I am, Adam. How are you?
Awesome. Were you able to see the web series?
I was. I really dug them. They're really, really great stuff.
Excellent. And well, why don't we start just by everybody saying what their series was and just a little bit about you guys. Why don't we start with Taking a Shot?
By Taking a Shot, our series was Devil's Couriers, the motorcycle club that goes against hipsters on scooters.
Loved it.
And we are based out of L.A.
Excellent. Okay. And then Hunter, you did what?
My name is Hunter, and our web series is L.A., which is also based in L.A.
Excellent. And Amy.
Nice.
Hi, Amy.
Hey. Hi. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, now we can. Yeah.
Can you? So my web series was Little Horribles, and it's sort of a dark comedy. And I'm also in L.A.
Wow, this is all L.A. Well, yeah. Except for Adam and I.
Yeah, and unfortunately, our Italian folks, they couldn't make it to the hangout. They really wanted to, but they had some other obligations to keep them going away. So let's just check and see if we have any questions. Let me just check and see what we got here.
Great job, guys. I really liked what you guys did. It was really excellent.
I agree. I think all of them were hilarious. I think actually the entire set was great. Amy, tell me, have you done a whole bunch of these episodes, by the way, of the Little Horribles?
Yeah, we've done 12, and are calling that season one, and then we're developing it for a couple other platforms and probably going to do a season two in the next month or so.
And how are you guys, what are you doing with it? Are you able to get it out there beyond? I mean, I guess I'm always curious about what web series are doing. Can you kind of elaborate about how you get it seen or what you do?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of it was about working with people who had like their own networks, whether it was like in the comedy world with like UCB or stand-ups in LA, or just like people online who have like really big followings. Like I collaborated with Issa Rae, who her web series Awkward Black Girl has a really big following, and she has a big following, and she just got is doing a pilot for HBO now, and so she helped get the word out and get us some press. And then we're going to be partnering with, you get sort of inundated with like other platforms that are interesting, and you have to figure out some deals are total shit and like you want to be careful, and some are better, and that's sort of what we're figuring out. You know, it just depends what your goals are, but a lot of it is just like same old hustle.
So LA, yeah.
Is it on, do you have all the episodes currently available?
Yeah, they're all of our episodes are just on YouTube. The channel is our production company, youtube.com/barnaclestudios.
Cool.
Great.
All right. Well, we had a question. We wanted to know, there's some crazy stunts you guys had in L.A. Tell us a little bit about how you guys were doing that. Have like a stunt coordinator, or are you guys just adventurous, or what was your experience with some of that?
Yeah, it was quite an experience. That was the most stressful scene I've ever filmed or produced in my career. The whole time I was just, praying that no one got injured or seriously hurt or worse. We got lucky. We did a combination of some of being risky, but we actually did go by the book. We had our film permit. I pretty much begged the LAPD to only let us have to hire two police officers as opposed to having four, which would have just, broke the bank for us. And we had to choose a road that was flat and even and not in a very high traffic area. So there's a lot of location scouting involved. And it also couldn't have too many intersecting roads that would be too dangerous. So basically, we shut down a road with two LAPD officers, had the permit. I also have a really good insurance person who got us much cheaper insurance than would have cost for actually what we were doing. We might have lied slightly on the form for exactly what we were doing, but the insurance and the LAPD and the film permit were by far the most expensive parts of that entire webisode.
Well, did you have a stunt?
So that's a kind of. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, you asked it. Yes, we did. That was the second most expensive part of that episode, was the stunt coordinator, who was actually Alvin Singh, who was the Asian actor who played the boss man who was on the hood of the Jeep. He was both an actor and he's also a stunt coordinator. He's actually in a lot of movies and TV shows. He's a pretty well-established guy, and he's also a friend of mine, so luckily he did it for a very small deal, and he loved the project, wanted to be a part of it. We're all kind of friends, so it just kind of worked out.
That's awesome.
Nice. Now, did you go under the SAG? Did you go under SAG low budget or new media contract, or what did you work on with that?
Exactly. Yep, that's what we did. We did both. We did the new media, and so it all worked out. So I mean, we did pay our actors, but all the contracts for the new media stuff.
Nice. And it looks like Adam Hall is back. Is that correct?
Yeah, with research.
So okay, you missed a little brief introduction. Go ahead and introduce yourself. Tell us a little bit about what your series is and what you've done.
Adam Hall. I wrote and directed a web series called Research, starring Barry Bostwick, Doug Jones, and a bunch of other people. It's basically an idiot wins a MacArthur Genius Grant and hires a bunch of crazy people to run a research facility. That's pretty much the
premise. Awesome pitch.
I graduated from USC a few years ago. I had a thesis film called Sudden Death that played like 100 film festivals or something, won like 50 plus awards or whatever. And now I am doing this, and I teach at Azusa Pacific University as well.
Very nice. So we got a question for Devil's Courier. Somebody wanted to know what some of your challenges that you had, and how did you guys overcome them? You guys had looks like you had a pretty big production there. At least you made it look big.
Coordinating everybody's schedule. I think at one point we had 40 people on set. For the later hipster battle scenes, and I really just coordinating everybody's schedule.
Yeah.
dealing with it was a SAG New Media contract, and we had a kid on set and an older lady riding a motorcycle, people on scooters and motorcycles, guns in public. So it was definitely interesting just to coordinate all that and not get arrested.
We also lost our location. Which had all our locations probably like a week. Or
less than
a week, so that was probably the biggest obstacle that we were set to shoot and we didn't have a location like a couple of days before, so it was like hit the ground running with Lucian, and it worked out for us because we found a better location, I think.
Yeah, I've never heard of
it
that
seems
happening.
Seems like it always happened.
That never happens.
Yeah, wow, that was unusual. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the location we lost was actually going to sub for three locations for the shoot. It was like we were going to cut it up into three separate places. So when we lost that location, it literally was like, what the F are we going to do?
Yeah.
Hey, this is the internet. You can say fuck if you want. Yeah. Oh, but I heard a baby. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's me, my one-year-old.
Oh, it's one-year-old, so that's okay.
They won't remember it.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that show is hilarious, by the way. I thought it was, like, that second episode just had me in stitches. I thought it was awesome.
Thank you. It gets much, much crazier as it goes. They're really short episodes, and one of the hardest things was structurally, because people have such ADD on the internet, coming up with an episode that's 2 to 3 minutes long, but it feels like it's 5 to 10 minutes long, where you actually get a full dose of comedy. So I think the hardest thing for us structurally is how to break these up. And our first season consists of 20 episodes. So that was challenging, because that's the first time.
Wow.
They
wow.
All 20 are available right now. So 20. Yeah, 20 episodes are out right now on the website. And that's our full season one.
Wow.
And did you guys shoot them all at the same time, back to back?
We shot six filming days, two cameras, and we just... 2-3 takes each. We had so many people on set that we just shot as fast as we possibly could and then cut it all together just so we could be at locations a little less and save money.
Right.
How big was your crew on that for shooting, if you're shooting that fast?
20 to 25 with 15 to 20 actors at some point on set.
Wow. That's great.
Well, I got a question. You know, it seems like a while ago everybody was talking about web series and just how it's, you know, kind of the new Wild Wild West, and now I feel like things have really kind of established quite a bit. And this is a question for all of you, what are you seeing are the future trends as far as creating content for the web and how you hope to continue doing so beyond what you guys have already done?
I guess I'll start. I guess what we want to use it as an incubator to showcase ourselves, and people, the younger generation watches it so much that now name recognition just from YouTube actors are you're starting to see them in the studio system a little more. So I guess for us it's just to really write something and get it out there and then become recognizable or get kind of a movement, so to speak, on the internet where a younger generation sees us and can recognize us. And also the popularity of Sons of Anarchy, we really just wanted to play off that and do something fun that other actors wanted to be in. So it was actually very easy for us to get a cast and a crew, because this is what people want to work on. They all shoot an action comedy was something that's really popular. So people really jumped on board early, so it was easy for us to get an ensemble cast with something like this. But we see it where we just keep doing seasons, and eventually we can edit all the seasons together where we have 2 hours of footage and then try and get it to Netflix or get it onto TV, which is really our future goal for this project.
But to also add to your question, I think you asked how we see web series in the future. I think you know, obvious that the internet's a new television, and so it seems like the internet it's mimicking what TV what's happened with network television. It's happening now, and the beauty of it is we have a lot more freedom as content creators. You know, we don't have to shoot a pilot and go to NBC. We can shoot whatever the hell we want, and you know, and the people speak. So I think that's where this is all going, I think, of the internet. We're at the tip of the iceberg of, you know, what you can do as a content creator online, you know, and, you know, not being limited by, to express your creativity.
Yeah, I think that's really true. With, like, we were just talking about that in the last web series panel, was that it's all about being able to do stuff that's creative and not have to, you know, work for the man.
Yeah.
Having control over your own stuff. What was that, Amy?
I was going to say, but you still want the man's money.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Always so after that's the man's dilemma. Money. Yes, that's true. That's really true. Do we have other questions? Is Mark, are you able to get questions?
I haven't got any questions yet myself,
you're,
no.
You're not getting fed questions. I'm looking here. No. I should be paying more attention to this, sorry. Yeah, Mark saw me before the set started. I was already drinking. And I'm drinking out of a mason jar, which is always a bad idea.
Yeah.
let's see. Oh, here we go. There was... you know, somebody had asked this question earlier, and I want to ask it again because I just think it's such a great question. For all of you, this is for all of you guys. You know, I've done a web series. Mark has done a couple of web series. This is a group of people that are experienced at doing this stuff. What are like your main what's the real reason of why you're doing a web series opposed to other stuff, you know, opposed to making a feature film or short films? I mean, is there any particular reason why you've picked this genre to concentrate in, other than to have full creative control, which I think you can still do as a, you know, as a feature or a short filmmaker too, but is there any other reason that people find, you know, their need to do this?
Well, I don't want to speak for everyone else, but I think it's pretty obvious to pretty much all filmmakers out there right now that all the opportunity is in television and on the internet. Feature films it's extremely hard to get a feature film made, and it's even harder to have an original film made. Any type of original idea that's not a video game, or a remake, or based on
comic book.
A novel or something like that, comic book, you name it. It's kind of the new golden age of television, and that also, obviously also the internet as well with web series and whatnot. I know our ultimate goal, we made a conscious decision. We were actually in the documentary game for quite a while, and trying to get some features off the ground as well, and we kind of jumped ship along with everyone else to television with premium cable networks, TV. Everyone has to have their own original program, whether it's the smallest channel on TV or even like Stars and Cinemax and those type channels. They all have to have original programming, so there's a large appetite for original content. So that's kind of one of the reasons that I think we're focusing on, web series with ultimately hopefully trying to get it on television.
I was going to say, I agree. I mean, I think that we're at a time where, TV is still the holy grail for everybody, and yet, it's still to a large degree, there's a lot of gatekeepers in order to, sell a series, and, I mean, now more than ever, it's yeah, there's more cable networks. They need more content. Everybody's scared to death of making any real bold choices. So there's this weird, unless you're established, it's harder to kind of have them pull the trigger. So if we do a web series, you kind of basically already have the proof of concept. You show them the show. You have an audience. People already like it. And, whether you're selling that show into television the guys are talking about, or you've got another project, they see that you've done it. They see that you have a fan base. And you're not sitting around trying to sell a feature or shoot a short film and try to get CAA to represent you just so that they cannot do anything with your career except tell you that, that should be great, but one more draft of that feature script would be awesome,
Yeah, and we were talking about this last year, Mark, weren't we? The fact is that there's a huge desire for this content, right? Can you talk a little bit more about that? I mean, internationally, it's people, they're dying for this kind of content.
Yeah, I mean, I think that it's obvious that we're, you know, more, I mean, the guys are talking about, like, the younger audience. I mean, definitely the younger audience is, you know, I mean, not so much on Facebook. I mean, the younger, like, really young, really on to, you know, Instagram and, you know, sticking with that and kind of smaller videos, but they'll be on YouTube watching, you know, content there. But I think that it's, you know, we're all, I mean, the percentage of time spent online is through the roof, you know, over the even in the last 2 years. And watching things online, you know, whether it's Netflix, you know, Hulu or whatever. So I think it's a great opportunity. I think people want to, you know, people want to watch content all the time. They don't want to be stuck with, you know, oh, it has to be what's on NBC or what has to be what AMC is, you know, willing to, you know, to allow on the air kind of thing.
Yeah, and I mean, personally, I don't think, like, all these web series I've seen today, especially all the comedies, are superior in humor than anything I would ever see on network television today, in my opinion. So.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I like the girl, you know, like, you know, Amy's, it was, like, very much, you know, has that, you know, Girls, HBO's Girls, and it has, like, a very similar, you know, not saying, but like the humor, the chances that you can take and that you can play with, it's fantastic. It's like, it's such a great thing, and there's an audience out there, you know what I mean? So I just think it's fantastic. Great job, Amy. I really dug it.
Yeah, I like Little Horribles a lot, too. Yeah. Definitely. Very funny. Well, as far as like a market too, you know, we were talking about this a while ago, and that there is a market. It's just we're not connecting the dots yet, but it seems as though there's a lot of people wanting, well, other countries that are looking for these episodic kind of series, and it's just a matter of us getting these series to the right distributors. But I mean, how do we go about doing that? Does anybody have any idea of how people are supposed to connect the dots?
I can kind of tell you a little bit from experience from what we're doing now with the show, because we're a little bit different. I mean, I love what the Devil's Curious guys are doing. I think they have probably a much better shot of getting on TV than we do because they have so much content and 20 episodes. We kind of actually made this to try to kind of make a pitch package to showrunners and to, you know, to networks first before we made it an actual, like, ongoing web series. So we're trying to get lucky, which most likely isn't going to happen because we don't have a celebrity attached to the project, which is what everyone in our meetings is telling us we need. But I can tell you, in today's times, for actual TV shows, it's all about the showrunner. It's all about, like you were talking about Girls earlier, Judd Apatow got involved and was basically the showrunner for that show. So showrunners kind of run the TV world now, and getting with certain people that can get you to the right showrunner is how shows are kind of are made. And so that's kind of what we're doing right now. We've been in a few meetings with Spike and DirecTV and Hulu, and we were lucky enough to get with Hammer Entertainment, who was kind of helping us through some of those gatekeepers, because we'd never be able to get them, you know, on our own, because we're relatively unknown. But it is still very tough, especially without a celebrity. So, you know, that's a challenge that we all have to face, unfortunately.
That's a good point. So is there ways, can you guys tell us about how we can follow your all of your, you know, web series? Like, first of all, with Adam, can you tell us how we can watch Research regularly? Or is there a domain?
Yeah, researchseries.com. That's really all you need to know. Links to Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, all that stuff is there. So researchseries.com, you can find the whole first season.
Awesome. And Amy, what about you?
Yep, similar, just littlehorribles.com, and everything is up there. All the episodes and all the social platforms and everything. So that's
good. Everybody makes it simple with just the the name.com. And anyone else? Hunter, you want to tell us how we can find you or follow you?
Yeah, we're on Facebook at I Love Hele, and Twitter is a Hele Life. And you can follow us there, and hopefully we'll have a few more episodes out pretty soon.
Great. Mark, what about yours?
Jeez. Well, I have like three projects that I'm doing the same thing that Hunter's doing, that basically we've shot, you know, sizzle reels, and now we're pitching them and, you know, hooking up with some showrunners and production companies and doing that kind of thing, as well as shooting a couple really low budget features that we just finished one and getting ready, you know, doing the distribution route on that. You know, so I'm, you know, it's me, I'm hustling always, trying to get something made.
It's always a hustle game. Yeah, for sure.
Yes.
And are you shooting all that stuff in LA? Or are you doing it up anywhere else?
Yeah, in Canada? Yeah, everything's been in LA so far.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. I'd love to see it. Can't wait.
I know. You and me both.
I was gonna say I bet you are too.
I'm like in, you know, color correction on three different projects and trying to, you know, get everything finished. So it's been a challenge, but it's all looking really good. Really excited.
Oh my God, you're really close. Okay. And what about you guys, Devil's Courier? That's obviously courier.com.
Website.
Okay.
Yeah, you can go to devilscareers.com and all 20 episodes are up there. Or you can go to the Google Play Store or the Apple Store and download our mobile app, which makes it even easier to watch.
No way.
Yeah, just type in Devil's Couriers. It's a fun little app, and it's been great for us. A lot of people have viewed it in the YouTube from the app, so it's been great.
That's great.
Tell us a little bit about how you got the app created. That's so fun.
That would be this guy, yes.
I created it through mobileconduit.com, a plug for them, and it's a pay service that you pay monthly for, but I researched probably 10 or 15 different ways to do it. We just wanted a simple player that we could put our content on, a little extra content, some fun stuff, but make it look very professional, and something that I can do, and I'm a medium, like, computer guy. I can do a lot of things, but I'm not a programmer. I don't write code or anything like that, so there was no way I could do anything like that. But this is a plug-and-play type thing, and I recommend it, mobileconduit.com, and that's what created our app for three. We have it on Amazon, we have it on Apple, and we have it on Android. Yeah, so.
Has that helped you guys out a lot?
We actually have a lot of views through there. We have a lot of people who use it. You can track it, so you can see how many people are watching at any given time, how many people are watching it every month through the app analytics, just like something like through Google. It's pretty cool. It's fun to have an app too, because you can always just sort of like pass it on to someone and tell them about it. And
it's nice because once they download the app, you can send them messages, which goes into their notification bar, so everyone knows when a new episode is up, because it's like a text message for them. So you kind of force them to either delete your notification or watch the show.
Try not to hound them too much.
Plus, when you're at a party, you can say you have an app. Yeah. It's pretty cool. So.
Yeah.
I do all my notifications at 3 a.m.
Yeah.
Like us all, yes. Okay. Well, thanks, everybody. I know I'm just hanging out here because I'm, like, dying here, but Adam and Marcus, you guys finish this up so that I can fall asleep here soon. Yeah. It's really good to see you. To meet you all.
Well, I guess I'll wrap it up for everyone. Again, great stuff. You guys are making some amazing content out there. I'm really impressed. I think the bar just keeps getting higher and higher. And, you know, we as creators get to write the rules. And, you know, as more of us connect and collaborate and create these relationships, I think we'll ultimately just be able to do all the things that we all hope and dream to do. So I encourage all of you guys, you're all LA-based, to get together at some point. We're having a live networking event tomorrow in LA at the Los Angeles Trade and Tech College. So please, if you can, show up, meet some other filmmakers.
Or come in on the lounge and hang out.
Yeah, or come in on the lounge. The lounge is off for now. We'll redo that tomorrow. But that's kind of where we're at. So thanks again for joining the unofficial Google Plus Film Festival. And we'll see you guys online.
Thanks, Mark.
Thanks, Adam.
Thanks, tomorrow.
Thanks, Hunter. Thanks, Jamie. Thanks, Adam. Hi. Thanks, everybody.
See you, Jamie. Thanks, guys. Good luck with everybody.
Thanks.
Bye, guys. Bye, guys.
Thank you.